Welcome to St. Louis and Busch Stadium, home of the Cardinals since 2006. MLB The Show has interleague action for you this afternoon. It's the Boston Red Sox taking on the St. Louis Cardinals. First pitch coming at you right after the break. All right, first pitch coming up. And on the hill, the lefty, Matthew Liberatore.
They're going to start this one with the opener because of the matchups. Very favorable. I think we're going to see him empty the tank with really good fastball velocity to try to retire these first three hitters.
And stepping in is the speedy Jaren Duran. 2-1 now.
Man, I mean, nice job just presenting it to be better than it actually was.
Kicks and fires. That one ripped right center field. And it's a one hopper off the wall. Should be extra bases. Now around second, going for third. And he'll get there as he kicks off the ball game with a triple.
He was all over that one. Off the bat, it was headed for the gap all the way. And as a hitter, you love seeing those as you take your first couple of steps out of the box. You know you've got some real estate to run on. It's such a good feeling. Nice liner into the gap right there.
It's Rafael Devers in the box. The pitch. And another ball.
Here's a player known for playing better in day games, which is not always the case. I mean, day games are different, bro. Things change from game times to your daily routine. But he sure makes the transition look easy.
And ball four to a board.
I don't think he really wanted to pitch to him right there anyhow.
So runners at the corners, nobody out. Here's Tyler O'Neill. Lefty out of the stretch, runners at first and third. And a count 1-2.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
The 1-2. Now it's belted. Deep to left. Way out of here. Home run. He powers that one out of here. It's 3-0. He absolutely crushed that one.
No doubt about that one, Boone. We knew it wasn't coming back. That's exactly the pitch he was looking for. Crushes it and hits it out of the ballpark.
Here's the Boston cleanup hitter, Willier Abreu. That one missed.
Can be tough to bounce back after a big home run, but nobody on, nobody out. You just have to treat it as a fresh inning.
Popped up. Gorman drifts towards it. Hauls it in for the out. And there's one down. Here's a check of the Red Sox lineup, put together by manager Alex Cora. We could be in for a power showcase today with the wind blowing out a lot of lift and separate, Chris.
We know hitters are in this era definitely trying to hit the ball in the air regardless of the conditions, but I think even a little more so, there's margin for error if you can get the ball up in the air. So, you know, you'll see at times, I'm sure, with two strikes, what looks like a half swing that can get out of the ballpark with a hitter who's got decent pop.
One down, base is empty. Headed down the line. And that lands in no man's land, a foul ball. Swing and a miss for the strikeout. couldn't catch up to the heater.
Just a mid-90s challenge fastball right there. Not much to it. And I'm sure he'd love another swing at it because it was in a very hittable location. Those are the swings where you can sometimes start to question yourself as a hitter and say, how did I miss that? But you know, it happens.
Laboring here, about to throw his 30th pitch of the inning. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. Kicks and deals. Swing and a line drive, base hit out of the center field. And that extends the inning.
Well, I don't think that pitch would have been called a strike, but he did such a nice job of pulling his hands tight to the body and just getting enough of the barrel on it to be hard enough back up the middle for a knock.
So two down, and now it's Garrett Cooper up to hit. And that's just foul.
Well, with this many pitches thrown here in this first inning, I mean, you're giving the other team a really good look. He's going to have to find a way to get some weak contact, maybe a swing and miss, get into that dugout and hit the reset button.
Fights that one away, still 1-2. Two outs. Out towards right center field. Nootbaar makes the play, and it's out number three. But the biggest swing of the inning comes right here, a three-run homer. It's now 3-0. It's Major League Baseball, and it's on the show. And we're back. And on the hill in this one, Nick Pivetta.
Anytime you have five pitches to work with on the mound, that repertoire can be a real weapon in terms of keeping hitters off balance, man. It's one of those things that I'm going to be looking for in this one. Does he have a feel for all of those pitches, or is he just able to get one or two over in the strike zone where he wants? Now, it's tough to do to be able to command all those pitches, but if he can, he is going to be very tough for the opponent today.
And here comes. Clobber to right field, way back, gone. A gigantic blast. And they're on the board. It's 3-1.
Gets pitch recognition early. He saw exactly where that was going to be. The challenge, not get over anxious and come out of your swing. He stayed on it and got all of it.
Lars Nootbaar now at the plate. And another ball.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up and you start to expect a big inning.
And the pitch.
Inside ball.
With the big bats coming up and a home run already surrendered, he's really going to have to execute against these next couple of batters.
And that one fouled off. Three, two now. And it's ball four. He missed down low.
It's tough after falling behind a hitter, two balls and no strikes, but now at least he gets a fresh start against a new batter. But he needs to get back into the strike zone and start pitching with conviction.
Here's Paul Goldschmidt. The 2-1. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. Nootbaar gets his lead at first. Nobody out. Cuts on it and misses. That's a strikeout. Couldn't hit the fastball at the knees.
Bogey just ran out of patience there. He took a couple of pitches to even that count up at two balls and two strikes, but that time chased outside the zone.
Here's Nolan Arenado. And the right-hander deals. Swings and misses, struck him out.
I mean, there aren't many curveballs in the sport today that break like that thing does. Huge movement. It's so difficult to get on the same plane and even think about squaring it up, let alone get a piece and hope he throws something else to keep the at-bat alive.
And stepping in for the Cardinals, Alec Burleson. Red Sox already leading. Swing and a miss, and he was fooled.
One ball, two strikes.
The 1-2. Swing and a miss, struck him out. And that is that. One in the inning, and it comes from a rather unlikely power source. It's now a 3-1 ball game. Major League Baseball is on the show. And welcome back to the ballpark. Now here is Zidane Rafaela. The wind of the pitch. And that one pulled foul. And a pitch. Rafaela tries to hold up. Appeal to first. Did not go. The pitch. Fly ball to right. Nootbaar moves under it. One away.
Batting nine. The second baseman. Vaughn
Grissom up next for the Red Sox. One out, base is empty. That one to first, Goldie. Steps on first for the out.
The center fielder, number 16, Jaren Duran.
Now batting Jaren Duran. Chris, his skill set straight out of the mid-80s. Good contact, not much power, and he could run. He always uses the wheels to his advantage.
His biggest challenge in this day and age is to not get caught up in trying to hit home runs because so many people are. I think baseball starting to understand that those guys are valuable like they once were. They need him in this game today.
Wouldn't chase that time. Rafael Devers waiting for a turn at the plate. Red Sox leading it by two. Here at the top of the second. Lifted in the air out to left. Drifts towards it. And that is that. Bottom of the inning. Now up for St. Louis. Mason Wynn. Swing and a miss. Chased it out of the zone.
Wow, no fair right there. I mean, that slider didn't move to the very last moment. Incredibly difficult to pick that up. Just kind of have to tip your cap on that pitch.
And there's a ball. Gary Simmons, our plate umpire today, sort of has a reputation as a pitcher's umpire.
Yeah, a little bit of a wider zone than most, I'd say. And a wide zone can be tough to deal with as a hitter because you have to start expanding what you're looking for, covering both sides, and with the stuff pitchers have today, you're just not going to have a lot of success. Very frustrating right there as a speedy potential base runner. With two strikes, you just struggle to put the ball in play. You don't even have to get a hit at that point. You can help your team just by reaching on an error, but in some way, you got to find a way to shorten up the swing and put the ball in play next time.
Here's Nolan Gorman. And now 2-2.
2-2, Cal.
One down, base is empty. Fouls it back with two strikes. And a pitch. In the air, out towards right center. Duran puts it away for the out. Two away now.
Batting it. The catcher.
Two outs, base is empty. Now the batter down, Ivan Herrera. The 1-1 is fouled off. Red Sox by two. Bottom half of inning number two. Not close with that one. And that's ball two. And down on strikes he goes. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Redbirds down quietly. And it remains a 3-1 ball game. Here in St. Louis, Rafael Devers up to hit.
Been a rough start on the mound for this guy. This third inning is so important for him to get on track, turn the page, settle in, do all those things you need to do to give your team a little bit of length in this one.
1-2 now. Foul ball left side. He'll see another. And that's down and away. That one misses. And that's ball three.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with the three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. In the air, out to center, Carlson sizes this one up. One up, one down.
Now batting the left fielder,
Tyler O'Neill, up next for the Red Sox. That's in there, and the count 1-2.
One ball, two strikes.
And another ball. Swings through it, and that's a strikeout. Went right after him there, Siggy. No messing around.
Three pitches right there. Three really good fastballs in that at bat. But what stood out is all of them in a different part of the zone. He started them away. You look out over the plate as a hitter, and then he busts you in. You're not quick enough to be able to pull the trigger and turn on it. And then he finished up in the zone. Good velocity. Caught the top part of that strike zone. That's a great example of how you mix your locations. Just as important as mixing speeds.
That's out to center field. Carlson sizing this one up, and he makes the catch, and that is that. Back here at Busch Stadium as we go to the last of the third. Here's the center fielder, Dylan Carlson. Why to kick the pitch. And another ball.
Well, he's so great about hitting the ball the other way. He gets those arms extended. So right there, just trying to straighten him up a little bit so he doesn't have as much outside plate coverage.
gets a piece and stays alive.
Flew open a little bit with that front shoulder, but was able to slow his bat down just enough to make contact with that pitch, keep the at bat alive.
Fights it off. You'll see another. Here comes a pitch. And that's in the dirt. And that one hammered. Way back there. See you later. He'll circle the bases. It's 3-2. He kept swinging and it paid off.
Well, that was a battle move again. He just kept taking his cuts. Finally squared one up. That one was a hanger, and pitchers typically don't get away with making a mistake like that. And right there, he made him pay.
Back to the top of the lineup, Brendan Donovan. Next up for the Cardinals.
Oh, just got to delete it. You give up that leadoff home run, go back to work, focus on this next batter.
One run across in the frame so far here in the last half of the third. Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. Ground ball to the right side. Smith takes it to the bag, one away. That ground ball may have him back on track after the home run. And up next for St. Louis, Lars Nootbaar. Though Chris, through the early stages, he hasn't been very efficient in terms of the pitch count. He's going to need to get some quick outs if he's going to get deeper into this game. And downstairs. It is interesting, though, when you consider the way the game is run now. Doesn't even matter that much if your starter doesn't go that deep, because teams are really aggressively building their bullpens. Line drive caught.
Nice swing and good solid contact. Smoke. Maybe a little more lift to get into the outfield gap. Maybe a little more backspin.
And here's Paul Goldschmidt. Two outs, bases empty. That one missed.
Two balls. One
strike. The 2-1. That's towards center. Under it. And that is that. One for the Cardinals on the solo home run. And the home team down a run. It's Major League Baseball on the show. Back here in St. Louis, and here is Connor Wong. This is a guy who is very highly regarded defensively. Fun to watch him control stuff behind the plate. Good game caller, good at framing, but it's that big arm that really stands out.
We got two balls, one strike.
You come into the game knowing that unless the ball's in the dirt or gets by him, we're probably not going to steal anything today. So that's where you want to get a little more aggressive on your secondary lead and hope that some base hits, some slugs, some home runs can come into play.
Swing and a miss, struck him out. Had him out front for strike three.
Got away with that curveball, no doubt about it. It passed right through the heart of the strike zone, and he just couldn't get the bat on it. When you strike out on one like that, that's when you start having conversations with yourself, and they're not usually very friendly.
Dom Smith stands in. In the air, right side. Brings it in, and there's two away.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
Two outs, bases empty. And now the DH, Garrett Cooper. On the ground. And foul ball. And another ball. And that skips into dirt. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. And he deals. Foul. We'll see another payoff pitch. Ground ball, left side. Throw pulls him off the bag, and he's safe.
You know, two out errors are kind of like two out walks, and sometimes even worse. You know, you think you're out of the inning, but all of a sudden, you get another out to get, and the offense has a great opportunity they're looking to take advantage of and make you pay for.
Here comes the skipper, and we're going to see a pitching change in this spot. Matthew Liberatore gives way, and a decent effort considering he's normally a reliever. Back with the new pitcher in a minute. New pitcher for the Cardinals, John King.
Just trying to keep this one close here, and this is where a bullpen can give their players a chance to fight back into the game.
Runner at first with two away. Still stepping in for Boston, Sedain Rafaela. Swing and a miss. Pulled the string on the changeup. One left for the Red Sox, and it remains a 3-2 ball game. And we're back. Here's Nolan Arenado. And when you talk about elite defensive third baseman, this guy's at the top of the list. Right side. And there's one down.
Up next for the Cardinals, no left field.
Alec Burleson next up for the Cardinals. That one out to right. Abreu on the move. Nabs it, and there's two down.
Now batting shortstop.
Mason Wynn will hit next. Singing, so you talk about a guy that has all the skills. The range is really good, but the arm just stands out, and he makes all the plays.
And because of that big power arm, he's able to play a little bit deeper, make throws from the outfield grass all the way across the diamond, and still get a pretty good runner. That's impressive.
Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Righty delivers. Swings through that one. It's a strikeout. 1-2-3 go the Cardinals. And it's still a 3-2 ball game. And welcome back to the ballpark. Top five, John Ciambi with Chris Singleton. And leading it off, Vaughn Grissom. Here's a 1-1. Ground ball, Goldie. Takes it himself. And the leadoff hitter retired in the fifth.
The center fielder, number 16, Jared Duran.
So the Red Sox lineup turns over. And now the center fielder, Jared Duran. Base is empty, one away. And we're at the top of the fifth. Line drive, base hit.
The
man aboard, and here is Devers. And a 1-1. There's a strike.
One ball, two strikes.
Duran, the runner at first, with one gone in the inning. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Good couldn't hit the fastball at the knees. And stepping in for Boston, Tyler O'Neill. Two outs. On the ground, out to short. Over to Goldie. And O'Neill is retired. That's the third out. And the Red Sox leave one. But they still lead it 3-2. We head to the bottom of the fifth. Here's the second baseman, Nolan Gorman. High fly ball lifted in the air right field. Abreu under this one. Drops into the glove. And a quick out number one.
Now catcher, Ivan.
And now it's Ivan Herrera. One down, base is empty.
Ball, that's outside.
Moving in the bullpen, Zach Kelly getting loose out there. Bernardino, the lefty, warming up as well. And strike two. That's down and in. Stays alive. The Red Sox up by a run. Last half of inning number five. Foul ball, and it remains a full count. And a pitch. Out to center. Hauls it in, and there's two away.
The center fielder, number three.
This is Dylan Carlson. Two down, nobody on. And a foul ball. The pitch. Out to short. Fires over to first. Third out. Nothing doing there for St. Louis. They're down 3-2. Back here in St. Louis, all set for the top of the sixth. And now, Willier Abreu. The pitch. Fouls it off, still 1-2. This to third. Nice grab. To first. It's there. And that's a great play.
I know they called Ozzie Smith the wizard, but Nolan Arenado, he's a wizard over there at the hot corner. It seems like we see him make plays like this on a daily basis.
Connor Wong up next for the Red Sox. And there's a ball. Down, base is empty. Fouls one off. 2-2. And now the lefty. And another ball. Up the middle, and that chance handled. Gets it to first. Two quick outs to open the top of the sixth.
Played that ball perfectly and got the throw off across his body as well as anybody could have. Any slower, and that was probably a hit.
Two outs, bases empty. Dominic Smith up next for the Red Sox. A swing and a miss as he chases way out of the zone. Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout. 1-2-3 go the Red Sox, but they're up 3-2. Back now for the bottom of the sixth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, Brennan Bernardino.
Still a lot of game left, and this game could go either way. So this is a big opportunity for him to get some important outs and try to help carry this lead into the later innings.
So the lineup flips over. Now it's the DH, Brendan Donovan. And the count 1-2. On the ground to the left. Devers throws on to first. One away, bottom of the sixth.
Such a confidence boost for a reliever to come into the ballgame and get the first hitter he faces. Just makes everything slow down a little bit, and then from there can really settle in.
Here's a 1-1. On the ground, right side. Smith takes it himself. Two up, two down.
Now back. The first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt.
Now it's Goldschmidt up to the plate. Next offering is in the dirt. The Red Sox with some bullpen action. Greg Weiser up and throwing. Number 71, a left-hander, also throwing. Two down, nobody on, here in the bottom of the sixth. Swing and a ball lined out towards center. Makes the grab, and that is the third out of the inning. And down in order go the Cardinals. They trail it 3-2. Back here in St. Louis, and now the DH, Garrett Cooper.
Red Sox, the designated hitter, Garrett Cooper.
And it is 2-1. The wind and the pitch. Just missed.
First pitch strike from the pitcher, but then no panic at all by the hitter. Very patient, showing good discipline. Now he's in the driver's seat with a 3-1 count.
That one fouled off. Payoff pitch. The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
Well, that could be a tone setter for the inning. Four straight pitches and leadoff batters on base. We'll see if the next guy waits until there's a called strike before he takes the bat off the shoulder.
The pitch. That one finds the zone. And it got 1-2. Shortstop takes a ball.
Well, with the amount of pitches that can end up in the dirt, a good secondary lead doesn't have to get away from the catcher. But if you're anticipating based off the trajectory, get yourself into scoring position.
Two, two on the way. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. Comes a 2-2. And swinging for the strikeout. pulled the string on the changeup.
He's locked in at the plate when he's using the whole field. He was out in front there. Just needs to let the ball travel a little more, and his timing will be back on track. Good pitch for the strikeout.
And next for the Red Sox, Vaughn Grissom. Ground ball could be two. There's one.
Out.
Wide throw pulls him off the bag, and the inning still alive.
Well, he had the chance to turn it two right there, but I don't think he got a good grip on the ball as he tried to transfer from glove to throwing hand. They say you can't assume a double play. I beg to differ at the big league level, but it's going to be ruled as a fielder's choice.
Jaron Duran up next for the Red Sox. Dives, but it kicks off his glove. No throw, and the defense comes away with nothing.
Good. That's staying within his game right there. I mean, this speedster gets the infield single, and now he's on base to possibly do some damage. I love seeing what guys like this can do to disrupt the game once they get in a position to do so.
Grissom over at second. Duran at first. Two out of the inning. Hot shot to first base, and he snags it to end the inning. We're back in a new pitcher here to start the bottom of the seventh. Greg Weiser.
And we all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man. And one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate's very high, and it just breaks a ton.
Well, one run game. Nolan Arenado getting ready to hit. And that's in the dirt. 2-1. Looking to get the tying run on base. Smith. He'll do it himself, and they get the leadoff hitter in the seventh.
That's what a good sinker is designed to do. Get a guy to roll over a little bit, hit the ball on the ground, kill some worms while you're at it.
Here's the left fielder, Alec Burleson. Kicks and fires. And a 2-1 hammered but foul. One down, base is empty. Still 2-2 after the foul ball. Battling here as he fouls it away. Trying to hold a one-run lead here at the bottom of the seventh. That one down the line, and it finds its way through for a hit. A perfect example right there. That plate discipline, it pays off.
The deeper he gets into a count, the more comfortable he becomes, and he usually wins the battle.
One down, runner at first. Now it's the shortstop, Mason Wynn. And that's in the dirt. The 2-1. Ground ball right side, down the line, and it's foul. The 2-2.
I got 3-2.
Following this count, runner not known for his speed, but I think you got to put him in motion. Try to avoid a double play here, Booth.
3-2. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. Right-hander kicks, deals. Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at-bat. Now new pitcher for the Red Sox, number 71.
Norman. Now pitching for the Red Sox, number 71.
Nolan Gorman, next up for the Cardinals.
You know, this is kind of a tough matchup as a left-handed hitter facing a left-handed pitcher. What you tell yourself is I want to stay square to the plate and try to hit the ball over the shortstop's head.
And another ball.
Typically, the outfield defense will play a little bit deeper just to keep the ball in front, make sure that runner on first doesn't come all the way around to score and tie this ball game up.
Two outs. And a swing and a miss there.
He's trying to stay away from this lefty, knowing that a lot of left-handers like the ball down and in.
The pitch. Wouldn't chase that time.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
Ivan Herrera in the St. Louis on deck circle. And here it comes. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Left-hand hitter waits. Foul. We'll see another payoff pitch. That one is absolutely belted. Carrying well. And forget it. Changes things.
Yes, it does. They were in striking distance. They found a way to fight back big time. Spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
And here is Ivan Herrera. Two down, nobody on, and a foul ball. And now the count filled up 3-2. That's hard hit on the line. Duran grabs it on the run. But two come across to score in the inning courtesy of this two-run homer. It's now a 4-3 ball game. Back after this on the show. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Andrew Kittredge.
Now pitching for the Cardinals, number 27, Andrew Kittredge. Leading off the Red Sox.
Drive deep right field. That's back there. And that one hops the wall. And the tying runs at second base with a double.
Well, that's how you respond. Leadoff man comes up, gets into scoring position. Now, there are several ways that they can get this run across.
Runner in scoring position, no outs. And now the right fielder, Willier Abreu. Red Sox with a chance to tie it up. Action in the pen down there. Brian Helsley, the closer, is getting ready and perhaps looking at a long save opportunity here. Number 64 also throwing. So the tying run at second. And here's a slow roller. And he picks it up in foul territory. Two two now. And that's ripped for a base hit. O'Neill flies around third. He'll score in time. It's 4-4.
Well, that at bat had a lot of pressure riding on it, so really great job coming through right there. It's got to feel good. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly. And now let's see if they force some action with good wheels on the bases.
And now the catcher comes up to hit. Connor Wong. That would call the strike. One and two.
One ball.
Righty to the plate. Now this is in the air down the line. He's got it. Oh, he throws it away.
The first baseman, number two,
Now it's Dominic Smith.
Definitely wants to stay out of the double play here. Ball on the ground in the infield. Should be an inning-ending double play.
Kittredge checks over to first, and he's back. Bounce to the left side, and it's just foul. That was close.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of the double play right here.
And the pitch. Fouls it back with two strikes. Tied at four. And that skips in the dirt. The 2-2. And another ball.
Way to lay off that pitch down.
Garrett Cooper on deck for Boston. With the go-ahead run at first, and we're in the top of the eighth. Foul ball, and it remains a full count. Right-handed reliever. Swing and a ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. And a go-ahead run into scoring position. One away.
Now, just a nice job coming through in a pretty high-leverage spot right there. Once you get the ball by the pitcher, there's a lot of base hits up the middle, even on ground balls. So a nice job to use that big hole and get himself a hit. And a huge opportunity now to grab the lead at this point in the game.
New pitcher on here. Number 64.
Number 64. Ryan.
So a change being made at first base. Pinch running here. David Hamilton. Now here's the Red Sox DH, Garrett Cooper. Two on, one out. And a good eye there.
Well, all eyes on the double play ball in this spot. No better way to get out of this inning.
Hit pretty well in the air out to center. Carlson settles underneath it. Snags it for the second out.
Now batting the shortstop today, Rafaela.
Zidane Rafaela up next for the Red Sox. Two on, two outs. And fouled off. And a 1-2. Got him swinging.
Sometimes he wears the emotion on the sleeve, but that's okay as long as he's getting results. And right there, thrilled with the punch out to get out of a jam.
Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Zach Kelly.
They know that he can get a right-hander out, but he's in position to face a couple of lefties this inning.
So coming into the game now on defense, Romy Gonzalez. He takes over as the new first baseman. Digging in is the switch hitting outfielder, Dylan Carlson.
For St. Louis, the center fielder, Dylan Carlson.
Line drive, could be extra bases. In safely with a leadoff double, go-ahead runs in scoring position.
Putting some good swings on the ball. That's his second extra base hit in this one. Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out finally, lifted into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great. Now a good opportunity to potentially jump ahead in this game here in the later innings.
Looks like we've got a substitution at second. Entering is the pinch runner, Michael Ciani. Brendan Donovan, the next to hit. Left-hand batter waits. Right through there for a strike.
Well, if he's going to do something special right here, it's going to happen with two strikes.
Kicks and deals. Now one close, rule the ball. Now 2-2.
Well, as a pitcher, when you make a big pitch down around the knees and don't get the call, it'll eat at you out there. So some handle it a little bit better than others. And right here, clearly letting the ump hear it a little bit.
And a swing and a miss. Not what you're looking for after the leadoff double. A strikeout, and there's one away.
Man, I really like the ability to bounce back right there after not getting the call. He probably should have gotten. He didn't let it affect his focus, and he came back with another good pitch to get him swinging.
Lars Nootbaar next up for the Cardinals. Right side, Grissom. In plenty of time to first, two away.
Not a bad outcome in that spot. The runner moves up to third, and now they have a chance to drive in the go-ahead run. It's not a knock, but at the end of the day, it's a good at bat.
And here's the first baseman, Paul Goldschmidt. With the go-ahead run at third, here the bottom half of the eighth inning. And another ball.
Concentration. Everybody on their feet, knowing that you can come through with a good swing. And there he doesn't try to do too much.
Nolan Arenado Next up for the Cardinals. And the righty deals. Swings through that one for strike two.
1-2.
Here's a 1-2. Slider misses outside. Got him looking. That's a strikeout. A run on two hits, and they leave one. Ninth inning coming up. It's the Cardinals 5 and the Red Sox 4. Now into the ball game on defense, Michael Ciani. He'll be patrolling center field.
63, Michael Ciani.
New pitcher on now, Ryan Helsley.
I can't imagine any save is an easy one. You're holding a small lead on the scoreboard, and you know those hitters are going to give you the best at bats they can. So it's always high stress. Let's see what he's got here to try and close it out.
They tried to get him to chase on a slider down and away. Pitch. That's a little bit low. Facing a closer that delivers big time velocity.
Well, normally against a big arm with this kind of velocity, you look for the ball down because the fastball up is a little hard to catch up to. But he's shown really good plate discipline by not offering at that last pitch down.
And that one lifted in the air center field. Gets there. He's under it. Calls it in, and there's one away.
The center is number 15.
And now, Jaron Duran. Feels like it's less common today that you see a guy like this. The speed component, the contact component, but lack of power. 1-1 now. Hardliner. Makes the catch for the second out.
Man, that's so frustrating. You hit the ball hard. You understand the situation. You want to get on base and try to score that tying run, but no reward right there, and just going to have to sit on it.
So they're down to their final out. And here is Devers. Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit. Joey gets on base and keeps it going.
These guys today are so great with handling velocity. They're seeing high speeds day after day, and a nice job of turning that one around.
Two outs, runner at first. Next to hit, Tyler O'Neill. Two outs. And another ball. Just missed.
Right now they're looking for something hit hard into the gaps. Give them an opportunity with two outs to score that run from first.
Willier Abreu up next. Late on that fastball.
Great RBI spot here. Just got to stay focused on the pitch. The runner will be in motion, so something in the gap should definitely score.
The Red Sox down to their final strike, and that's ball four.
walks out of the bullpen can absolutely kill your momentum very quickly. There's some hot water trying to protect this lead.
Now, Willier Abreu. So the tying run at second. Just missed.
This is the guy they turn to get the most important outs of the ball game, but they're going to make him work to get this save.
And that one fouled off. Pitch misses, ball three.
Well, comfortable or not, these are the situations closers they seem to live for. When you get into some hot water, a jam, tough spot, whatever you want to call it, but this is where they earn their keep.
Two on, two outs. Foul off the plate, they'll do it again. At the belt and fires. Bounce to third. Arenado. Throw to first. Ball game. And the Cardinals hold on to win a tight one as this one ends as a one-run ball game.
Well, this turned out to be an exciting, very well-played game. Always feels great when you can take the lead in the eighth at home. Come out in the ninth, the crowd will be behind that pitcher as he tries to get those final three outs. Everybody goes home happy with a win like this.
First for the big kick, the St. Louis Cardinals. Five runs, six hits, one error. They left two runners.